Fresh talk to him.
This is Spec Weekly. I'm Cutcraft, delivering your dose of IOTA Hopium. Join me as we take a look at what happened last week.
Read the disclaimer, baby.
Let's go. We covered the big infrastructure integrations in the last episode, and in today's episode, we look at the projects that have received a grant. Some of these projects are also infrastructure related, but more on the services side. For example, some of these projects provide back-end services when new IOTA-based projects develop a front-end that integrates with the back-end. Maybe this new project configures the back-end tools a little to give their platform some unique advantages. So, let's go through grant recap number one, the first wave of grant recipients. Great to see Dark Mythos is still in the mix and expanding their offering. Dark Mythos is a trading card game slash ecosystem that merges trading card games with Web3 tech. Dark Mythos NFT holders connect to the Dark Mythos website and use the on-site dApp to play. The Dark Mythos team are developing their platform to make it accessible and educational for newcomers, but also optimizing it so that experienced players are entertained. Personally, I've never played a trading card game, but I do like how they work. I'm into shit like Dungeons & Dragons, and I imagine this is kind of similar. Might have to try it out and test their newcomer tutorials when they become available. Figment is an NFT marketplace. The team is gearing up to establish itself as a blue chip project, and they're gonna look to integrate DeFi. But regardless of the DeFi functions they include, Figment is still predominantly NFT focused by offering advanced features, incentives, and a launchpad for artists. Figment will offer incentives like airdrops and farming systems, while also providing utility to NFT holders through staking and secondary fee earnings. Figment will be an IOTA EVM exclusive. Not sure if they will be forever, but as of launch, they will cater only to IOTA. I've spoken to the team behind Figment, and I'll be looking to get a little more involved with what they have going in the coming months. Now, this one is interesting. I'll tell you, these motherfuckers are looking to steal my job, bruh. Now, I'm just kidding, but seriously, this has nothing to do with me. But let me just say, I'm happy to see that there will be more content. I miss my boys Thomas and IOTA Poet. I hope they'll come back too. So, IOTA Media is an independent media distribution brand focused on the IOTA ecosystem. They will push to keep the current IOTA community engaged while also attracting new ones. The brand's portfolio will include a website, newsletter, X account, Discord server, Telegram channel, podcast, and YouTube channel, all working in tandem to deliver ecosystem-wide and protocol-specific content. This content includes news, insights, interviews, education, research, and entertainment, forming an integrated top-of-the-funnel strategy. Bruv, this sounds like Spec Weekly. You know, maybe I should put a proposal through. I just really can't commit right now because of the new elites. But maybe in the future, we'll see. If IOTA Media got one, I sure as hell better get one too. Anyway, Godspeed, IOTA Media. Can't wait to support you guys when you start doing content. I couldn't find any links, so I imagine they will announce something when they have their workflow ready. Gamma Strategies is a liquidity management and market making service for decentralized exchanges. They are a TVL leader among liquidity managers and are also leaders in volume as well as fees generated. Gamma offers a full suite of services, including active liquidity management, backtesting, and they also do liquidity analysis. Gamma's decision to expand to IOTA reflects a desire to attract builders, traders, and users to our network, fostering ecosystem growth. Well, this all sounds very good. I'm hoping that Gamma enables IOTA liquidity pairs on decentralized exchanges like Uniswap, for example. getting IOTA to trade on the biggest EVM chains would get our beloved IOTA token more exposure. Welcome to the family, Gamma. Please do your best. Uncx Network is a DeFi services provider offering services including liquidity pool locking, token vesting, token minting, farming as a service, and a launchpad. Operating since 2020, Uncx became a prominent player in the crypto space, boasting over $600 million in total value locked across multiple chains such as Ethereum, Binance Smart Chain, Polygon, Avalanche, Base, and Arbitrum. Extending its services with IOTA EVM includes promising mutual benefits and further growth for both parties. Now that sounds pretty cool. Uncx looks like a fantastic back-end service provider for the degen DeFi stuff that's bound to appear on the IOTA EVM. We're already seeing lending and perpetual platforms, and I'm sure there will be more when the liquidity and TVL starts to rise on the IOTA EVM. IOTA Heroes, one of the projects that are close to my heart. It's a GameFi project where players can train and equip their characters, which are NFT avatars, and then send them out on adventures where they fight enemy creatures. And on top of that, IOTA Heroes also has player versus player tournaments. I like IOTA Heroes because it is a platform on the IOTA EVM that gives us something to have fun with. I think it's important that the EVM offers more than DeFi degeneracy. While yes, having weird ways to make money is what will bring in the liquidity, I have to say that GameFi is just as important to build up in order to bring in some new interest. I'm excited to see where Christian takes his project, and I'm very happy to see that he received a grant. Now onto FomoFox. And I like the idea they're introducing with their project. FomoFox is a pioneering meme coin that introduces a unique storytelling approach where the story changes to match what is happening with the token's price. With FomoFox, token holders can directly influence the narrative, blending the meme with what's happening in crypto, with a focus on the IOTA ecosystem. For example, the FomoFox shits himself when the price goes down and gets stoked when the price goes up. FomoFox has got strong and consistent branding, and I've been seeing a little bit of shilling in spec. So well done, lads. Last on the list for the first series of grants is Token Labs. It's a platform that gives the IOTA community the ability to create and finance ERC20 tokens. Using the tools on Token Labs only requires a small fee. They aren't selling NFTs or tokens to crowdsource. I like their approach, and when I have the time, I will definitely investigate how to use Token Labs so that we can create the shittest coins on the IOTA EVM. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna create a shitcoin contest. Whoever creates the shittest coin gets a prize. I'm talking shitness on the level of Harry Potter, Obama, Sonic 10 Inu, or Cum Rocket, or Dog Elon Mars. I want to laugh. There's just too much sadness lately. And with the liquidity our community holds, we could make a microeconomy for shitcoins. I know all the serious motherfuckers in the community will hate on it, but you can't make everyone happy. We can have our own fun. So here's the challenge we'll do. When Token Labs launches their platform, I'll do a walkthrough of how to use it, and with that information, you guys can create a coin that is so shit that it makes me cry. You guys send me some of your shit coin, and I'll make a list. We'll do some polls on Twitter, where the community decides which coin is the shittest. And it must have a shitty logo too. And the winner gets a USDT prize on the IOTA EVM, or something like that. I'll see if I can get some money. IOTA Foundation, are you listening, bruh? Give me some money so I can give it to the community for creating shit coins. Let's see if I can raise $1,000 US. So Token Labs, I'll hit you up to see when you're ready, and then we'll have a little shit coin contest.
Okay, that's the first recap of successful grant applicants who are helping build the IOTA ecosystem. Granted, everything is IOTA EVM, and everyone who is still in IOTA only for the industrial level adoption will be disappointed. But guys, this is crypto. And if we want IOTA to be known, we need to do these things. DeFi, NFTs, GameFi all need to be in the mix. Everyone is feeling down about the price. But a contributing factor for why the price is down is because we don't have a presence in the market for DeFi, NFTs, and GameFi. But as we can see, that's what the IOTA EVM is starting to enable. And if you want that price to move in a positive direction, then you need to shill this stuff too. And if you don't want to shill it, but you still want to see the price of IOTA go up, then at least try to be less cynical about these projects in public forums like Twitter. It doesn't make sense to shit on the people and the projects who are trying to build up this ecosystem. I've already seen the cynicism on my project, The New Elites, even when I've engineered pretty much everything to be community focused. So just chill, lads. And look, if you ever find yourself feeling down, all you have to do is remember, $4 EOY. See you next time.